Dear students and dear farmers, in the case study lesson series, in the last two classes, we have seen one class for crop management and another one for disease and pest management. Now, at this class, let us discuss how the agro advisory prepared based on weather forecast is going to minimize the risk in animal sites, because animal component also comes under agriculture. With this, let us move to the next slide, wherein the AgroMed advisory for foot and mouth disease in milch and draught animals is studied. It is a case study. This foot and mouth disease is very serious during monsoon season across India, and if this disease comes, means there is greater loss in milk production from milch animals, and the draught animals cannot be used for drawing agricultural implements. Thereby, we lose efficiency from the animals that are being kept at our farm sheds. Now, here there is a weather situation. What is the weather situation for this case study? Monsoon season. Other than Tamil Nadu and Jammu and Kashmir, in all states of India, the monsoon season comes from June to September. For Tamil Nadu, the monsoon season is October to December, wherein we get abundant rainfall. So, when monsoon season, when rainfall situation occurs, along with high relative humidity, this is the weather situation being communicated to the farmers. When this weather situation occurs over 4 months or over 2 months, then the sensitivity of the animal is to get viral infection. That means the animal is vulnerable to viral infection. Virus also abundantly available in the environment. When animal and virus, vulnerable animal and the virus meet together, then the incidence of this foot and mouth disease gets inflated. So, the proposed AgroMed advisory is to go to the veterinary hospital to get vaccinated against this viral disease. When you take the animals to the veterinary hospital, they give the vaccination rightly, the animal is being protected. This is a case study taken for this foot and mouth disease that occurs with milch and draught animals. Let us see some more case studies also for this animal sector. Here the same situation, monsoon rainfall is there, high relative humidity is present, but the disease is mastitis. The flattening of your udders, milch udders, cow, especially milch animals, it gets contaminated with bacteria. This is a bacterial disease. So, the teats gets plagued, no milk will come, teats gets plagued. So, this disease is very common during monsoon season, and the sensitivity of the animal in this bacterial contamination is very aggressive during this season. So, thereby you will be losing the milk, total milks against, if suppose an animal gives about 4 to 5 liters per time, means you will be getting only 500 ml or 1 liter milk, that too with the blood stains. So, not hygienically good. So, it must be treated. What must be done? A simple solution. Before and after milking, you treat the udder before mastitis comes with 1% potassium permanganate solution. Prepare the solution before milking. You clean the udder with this solution and after milking also you clean the udder, thereby we can prevent the disease to get infected with the animal. This is very very cost effective, inexpensive treatment. So whenever monsoon comes, means the agro advisory is being given to the farmers that you protected your animal from this mastitis disease. These two are related to animals. Let us see one example for poultry also. Poultry industry is also getting very important in India, so that must be also looked into in terms of your agromed advisory based on your weather forecast. The situation is wind speed more than 20 km during day time, and also prevalence of dry weather. Dry weather means in the temperature may be more than 35 degree centigrade or 32 degree centigrade. No vegetable, no rainfall, dry day, no rain. But the wind is more. This we could see during summer months, especially March, April and May. So the sensitivity of the poultry is they can't take their feeds enough, because though you keep enough feed, since the cage is ventilated, the air or wind gets into these cages and trips your food kept for the poultry. They say that about 30% of the food is being dripped by the wind that enters into the cage. So what should be done? Whenever the wind speed is more than 20 km, whenever there is a prevalence of dry day, and this forecast is given to the poultry farmers, then they must do is cover the cage. Cage means 100 birds cages or poultry shed. Cover the poultry shed or screen the poultry sheds with the sacks on the sides, so that you are blocking the wind to be entered into the cages, so that the feed is not drifted away from the cages or the poultry shed, so that the enough feed is taken by the animal. The present practice generally prevalent with the farmer is no adaptation strategies, because they are not bothering about the loss of feed being taken by the wind, but this must be considered. So these are the some few examples I have discussed for this poultry also. So far we have seen the case studies for crop management with reference to our weather forecast and agro advisory, and also insect and pest disease management, and also poultry. In the next class, we will see the economical analysis for these case studies that is being studied by us. That is very, very important. Economical benefit is always very, very important to accept or do not accept your agro advisories. That will be discussed in the next class. Thank you very much for your keep attendance. Thank you.